Church.
Amen. Amen. It's very important to maintain some relationships while you have a relationship like a husband and a wife.
Oh, absolutely.
And it's very important for you to let some of those friendships go that you have while you're husband and wife. You know, the couples that are stagnant, the couples that are not producing God's will for their lives, but you have some type of connection with them, and you decided that, hey, I'm just going to help them and I'm going to be there for them. And anytime you ever need me, you ever made that statement to people, hey, anytime you ever need me, you know, whether we're in the same organization or not, you call upon me and I'll be there for you. And then we stay in commitment to those individuals, and those that are not healthy relationships, they can be not healthy, is what I'm saying.
So
the non-healthy relationships that you and I are feeling committed to, and we're loyal to them, we need to dismiss those types of relationships. And so when we're explaining to make commitments outside of the home, we want you to decrease to the commitment that is not going anywhere. In other words, put your time and effort in someone who is producing results. And so they're manifesting for their lives God's will. So you're going to be a part of that by giving in to that relationship or that friendship.
Spend time with family, because God is about family. He's about covenant relationships. But oftentimes what happens is when we overextend ourselves, we become burnt out, tired. And then God, how is he being glorified in that? Like when you look at 1 Corinthians 10:31, it says right here, do I have 1 Corinthians 10:31? I do have it. It says, therefore, whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. Right. Amen. And so, but this is a good standard of behavior for us to be partakers of. Because we want our behavior to glorify God, right?
Amen.
But we have to ask ourselves, would this action put God's reputation in a good light? Am I glorifying God in this relationship, whether it's ministry, whether it's friendships, whether it's families and things like that? Because it's so, we can have like different sets or types of friendships, but are they covenant relationships?
Yes.
Because covenant relationship is so important.
Yes.
And that's what we talk about in the very beginning of Marriage Monday. We talk about what the definition of what marriage is. And it's
right.
What? It's a covenant relationship. It's an institution that was created by God.
Absolutely.
We're in covenant relationship with God.
Amen.
For those who have accepted Jesus Christ. So that's, you know, when you're just dealing with the commitments outside of the home, the family, the friendships, the ministry, slash the church. And it doesn't mean that you don't love those people or those type of the friendships. It just means that you recognize and acknowledge that all of us are at different places. And so if it was a couple who really sold out for God at one time and they were involved in ministry, it doesn't mean that they don't love God now, but it's just somewhere different. And I think that we have to allow and extend, give the grace. It don't mean that you won't ever fellowship with them, but it's just really all about, first and foremost, your relationship with God, that covenant relationship, and then in your marriage, and then you can extend out and we should to other marriages, because I think that when you have good relationships, friendships with those who are married with other married people, you can glean from one another.
Sure can.
You, at least you should be able to.
I would hope that you would be around someone that you could glean from.
Yeah.
Versus always, you know, sucking the life from your nurturing, you know, relationship.
Yeah. Or vice versa.
Hopefully you can have some. But yeah, hopefully you're not leeching off of anyone. But we're speaking in perspective of you, the couple, committing to outside of that inner relationship that you all have.
Yeah.
There's a responsibility that I have with my wife, and there's another responsibility I may possess as a friend, right? Or a family member, like I am a son, I'm a nephew, you follow what I'm saying? I'm a grandson. And so there are roles that you fulfill within the relationship of family, right? Yeah. There's friendships you developed over time that you need to seek out and reestablish. There's some friendships that you've been entangled with for some time, and you need to let those particular relationships be the one to dissolve. They're not helping your marriage union at all, actually. And so you want to deplete from that type of distraction, I'll call it. Amen. And when you look towards ministry, you want to, as a couple, get involved in ministry. You want to let your election be made sure. You want to allow God to use the gifts that are sown in you, that are given to you by Him. Amen. And there's some assignments that you all have as couples that you haven't even embarked upon yet. So ministry will help you get involved in that, but you get involved together as a family, and a family is a man and a woman, right? Coming together in the divine institution of marriage. Amen.
Amen.
And then the children are added to that family. Amen. So there's something you need to be doing for your family. There's something that you need to be doing for ministry or in ministry. How about your church? How about your church? Is there anything that you can do as a couple to help your church along? Is there any position or role that you can play as a couple to help advance the plan of God for other couples? Amen.
Amen.
So when you consider your vice of working together, you consider the fact and look at the progress. Last week, you worked on your commitment to the word together. Amen. You follow me? And as an individual, this week, you commit to outside relationships and family and friends and things of that nature, but do it in a balanced way.
Yeah.
One that you and your wife, one you and your husband agree upon.
Yeah.
You're not going to always be over Auntie So-and-so's house or fixing grandma's sink. You follow me? If you're the husband, and you're not always going to be over there doing that and making sure that she has her food. There are people for that, right? You follow me? But you can do what you can do, and you can do it within the measure of your relationship with your spouse. And that relationship does not have to get damaged because of the other relationships that you have.
Yeah,
amen.
Yeah, amen. And I like that, Pastor, because it is about working together and coming together as a team. And as quickly and as easily as we are to go out to help somebody else, the ministry first begins in our home.
In our home.
And just like, really, for transparency, Pastor Kofi and I, my husband, we had to recently evaluate how we and what we were committing ourselves to. Like, we've entered into a new season in our life as a family, as a couple. And so we saw that the importance of being able to identify what we were doing and where God is taking us, and things we needed to do, things that we needed to understand, where we were, where we are, right? And I know for me, there were moments that I was feeling really overwhelmed. And so we had to take time to discuss it. Like, it's a lot when you're involved in ministry and when you're learning technology and when you're depending on people or person or persons to help you, and you have to commit to their time because you have to be respectful of their time, and especially when they're serving as a servant, meaning like you're not exchanging time for dollars and things like that. And so in your marriage, so that we don't become overwhelmed, we have to discuss what's needed for the marriage, but also what's needed for us to be able to have a marriage that is that's going to continue to be fruitful, mm-hmm. so God will be glorified in it. And so here's a suggestion that we come to make to you. That is to write everything down that you and your spouse are committed to. Mm-hmm. So that way you can prioritize and maybe reprioritize and see what could be eliminated. Mm-hmm. Take Amen. Time to pray over each item. Take time to talk about it. Mm-hmm. Take time to understand what season that you feel that you're called to, and then take the action that's needed. Mm. Remember, it is beautiful. Necessary in order for you all, for us to do our best at what we're called to do, that it, we want to glorify God in it. So remember, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. So whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do all for the glory of God. And remember, everything that we do, it should be done unto the Lord.
Hallelujah. Everything. Amen.
Amen.
Everything we do should be done as unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the one thing that we should do as a couple is to manage and to beautify the institution called marriage that he gave us. Amen?
Amen.
He wants us to do that as unto him. And literally it's because we have a covenant with him. Amen?
Amen.
A covenant, a divine institution where two rational free moral agents chooses to enter into a what?
Covenant.
Covenant with the who? Almighty God. To
covenant
do what?
Right.
Stay with an imperfect person. Amen. Amen. And so you're going to have to make that commitment first. Amen. To Amen. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And then you'll have to make the commitment to each other to stay on the wall of your relationship, to work out together, to witness to each other's bodies together. Amen. Because you are a couple. God allowed you to be fitted together. And he said, what he joins together, let what?
No man
put asunder. Amen. And so you need to continue to work out together, to talk as you walk in the neighborhood, and while you're on the treadmill next to each other, you walk and talk and you get together and you love on one another and you discuss things. And as you begin to do that, you understand that you need to get in the word. You got to have your devotion with God.
Hallelujah.
You got to have your marination time with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
So you got to get in that word, and you got to read your Bible as a group together, as a couple, and you have to read your Bible individually.
Absolutely.
So that God can speak to you concerning your walk with him. And then tonight we have learned that we make commitments outside of the home. And so we're making commitments outside of the home with family. We're making commitments outside of the home of friendships that we have. We're making commitments outside of the home with ministry and with our church life. Amen.
Amen.
And the list goes on. And so you're free to move about the cabin with that list, but do it together on one accord with each other, understanding the barriers and boundaries that are set forth. You don't want to be over someone's house and follow me by yourself or anything like that. You get what I'm saying? You're doing it as a couple, and you're doing it the way God intended for you two to do it together. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, we hope this message has encouraged you, has lit your soul on fire for the Lord Jesus Christ to be a servant. Because the Bible says to be what? Great is to be a what, baby?
Servant.
A servant. And so you're going to serve your friends, your family, your church, your ministry. You're going to serve God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
As the family, you and your wife, you and your husband are going to be the dynamic couple that changes your environment and your whole address area. You're going to be the couple known as the couple that believes in God, the couple that trusts God, the couple that moves forth in the Lord. You're going to be known for being that in your neighborhood, because you're going to follow the things that we've talked about tonight. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Go impact your family. Go impact your community and do what God's called you to do as a couple. Amen. If you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you've not asked him into your relationship, let me tell you, you are avoiding a recipe that definitely works. The Lord Jesus works in our relationships.
Yes, he does.
To the T. I mean, he will help you understand her, and he will help her understand you. It will go that way with the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
So you need to invite the Lord Jesus Christ into your heart, your life, and into your marriage. And if you do that, while you're at it, the power of the Holy Spirit can help you put to death things in your life that shouldn't be there. And so if you need to stop talking to her like that, or talking to him like that, or treating her like that, or treating him like that, the Holy Spirit will give you power, dunamis power, to behave the way a man of God should and the way a woman of God should. Amen? Yeah. So allow God to be in your life and allow to fix some things in your life so that you can be the best husband or the best wife that he's ever called you to be. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Well, ILM loves you.
But more importantly,
God
loves you.
We'll see you Sunday.